Hello, this is WWE superstar Tyler Breeze. These are my top five video games. I think number five is Grand Theft Auto. I'm just gonna kind of use the franchise in general because everyone is awesome in its own way. I remember playing the earlier ones, Grand Theft Auto 2, I believe, where it's all like 2D and you're kind of, you know, driving around, whatever. All the way up into the latest one, where it was super complex and all that other stuff. I don't know, it was fun. The initial concept was fun, if you could just run around, do this stuff, you know, drive cars or beat people up or whatever. Or it kind of got, you know, more complex into like, you know, you had missions or you had cars, you could upgrade your cars, you could take them to the body shop and, you know, upgrade them and keep them and all this other stuff. So that kind of was my favorite part of it. Next one, I'm gonna go with Army of Two. One and two. I don't know, I can't pick favorites. I like both of them. Just basically the whole, you know, concept of just two people. It's Army of Two, it's you and one of your buddies and you're just going through kind of, you know, all these missions and, you know, it's just kind of cool. It's the same thing. I'm very much like I like the customizable effort of a game where you can customize, you know, everything down to every little part of whatever it is or skill trees or whatever. I like all that stuff. So Army of Two, definitely in there. Next one, I'm gonna go back a little bit with Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, the arcade game. Very specific, the arcade game. I remember I played it one time, loved it. Went to buy it, couldn't figure out which one it was. I think my dad had like some normal, like he just had some games and one of them was a Ninja Turtles game, but it wasn't the arcade game. It was the one where you're in like the turtle van and you're kind of like driving around, and that one was especially hard. That one was even harder than the arcade game. Most of them had no save or like game over was game over. You had to start over. So it made it ridiculously hard, but I tried that one forever. Couldn't get anywhere on it. Arcade game came out, couldn't get anywhere on that one. So I had to get, you know, friends to join in and whatever. So it was a group effort. I'm gonna switch it up with Monster Rancher. It's called Monster Rancher. And the whole beauty of Monster Rancher was that every disc had a different monster on it. So like every CD, like CDs, DVDs, all that stuff. So you would literally like start and then you would go through, like my mom, his mom, like everybody had these extensive movie collections or CD collections. And we used to just like, you'd go, hey, try to farm this one, pop it in there, new monster. Pop it in there, new monster. So we go through like hundreds of CDs trying to find all these monsters, and then you kind of like train them, and then you go through this whole thing, and you fight them in tournaments and all that stuff. Really cool concept. I think I still own the game. And last but not least, probably the game that's taken most of the hours out of my life, Diablo 2. Because Diablo 1 was cool, but it was clearly like the first. It was just like trying to kind of figure out what Diablo was all about. Diablo 2 knocked it out of the park. The monsters, like the actual, so it had it broken down into acts. And so like, I think it had like four or five missions per act. And then there was like four acts plus an expansion pack, which was five. And then they had like these main bosses you had to beat, all these difficulties where you could blow through like the normal difficulty really easy. And then the second hardest difficulty, I think it was just hard maybe. It was like hard and nightmare, or it was like normal, hard, nightmare. Yeah, something like that. But when you do it on hard, you had to like collect these certain sets of armor and these sets of, you know, it's all the customizable stuff that I love. So basically you just play nonstop and you beat the same guys over and over and over because they drop different stuff every time. So then you would get that stuff, but then you would also trade it. And then you'd also go to like these other little, you could open up a game at any time and then you'd go in and then somebody would be giving away random stuff, or you'd have like a million things, or you could, eventually they had this cube that you could toss everything in there and make new stuff. It was pretty cool. I'm Tyler Breeze. Those were my top five games. Leave comments below. Let me know what your top five are.